gender dimensions are not at all taken into account in the knowledge production process or research content. And finally, understanding of gender in the very gender equality policies. Women are mainly in focus, there is a silence on men, there is no problematization of men, and very little problematization of intersections of gender.
I've been studying women in academia for a long time myself, and being a woman in academia.
As it has been quite clear during the day, there are multitudes of gender gaps in academia, and just very shortly, there are multitudes of gender gaps in education, very persistent horizontal segregations by study fields, gender issues are not addressed or integrated in many educational programs.
Yeah, because student numbers are really high, women undergrads and women graduating. Already for 50% in many countries, most countries in the world, and this is creating this kind of alarm debate, women taking over in academia. But
this is a long list. I just list here some key issues which are to be looked upon when looking at gender and research funding. We should look at the applicant pool and applicants and application behavior. Who applies, who doesn't apply, how many potential female and male applicants are there in so-called application pool.
Universities are seemingly gender neutral, gender doesn't play any role.
Is there unconscious bias in the review? Do the reviewers focus on, or are they told to focus on the track record of the researcher or the proposal content and quality? Gender dimension in the research content, is very important. How is that evaluated, or is it queried, is it interrogated, or is it ignored?
When you look at what's going on in academia, that is definitely not the case. Universities are seemingly gender neutral, gender doesn't play any role at the surface, but when you look at more deeply, gender plays a huge role and not always.